Hey everyone, what is up? My name is Leah and welcome back to Text-Based Innovations. Got a pocket full of gold. What's your advice? Anywhere you wanna go. Oh, trust that's nice. You got me on a good day. Oh, tell me what you like. I'll get it right. I'll get it right. Super quick and easy video today, guys. We're gonna take on connecting our motors to our brain and then our brain to our computer. Let's get into it. Okay, so the chassis looks a little bit different since the last time you saw it. It is the same type of chassis, but I added on these plates separated by standoffs so the brain, the radio, and the battery could rest on them and easy viewing. So you always want to place your brain in a nice, easy spot that you can always have access to it, so you can keep like touching it. There's not really many parts needed for this, guys. I screwed these on with some very tiny bolts. They just kind of just screwed right into the back of the brain and the radio. There is a plate that came with my brain, the cover, and it's magnetic, so you can just take that off when you wanna use the touchscreen. So the stuff that we do need to connect is cables. Okay, so here are our cables, and there's a bunch of them. I'm just gonna take out a few just to get the right size that we need. It's up to you what size you want, but this one's a really long one, as you can see. This one's same size. This one's a little bit shorter. There's a really short one over here. And so there's just a bunch of different sizes. Don't need that. Okay, so now that we have our cables here, we need our robot to connect them, to actually use the cables. So let's get them out. Okay, so we got our brain. So this is where we're gonna be connecting our cables. So in the top of the brain, there are spaces for the plugs of the cable to go into. And on the bottom, they're the same ones. On the side, we have another cable, which this one, 21 on the side, is specifically for the radio. And then we have a bunch of other ports here, but this one, these two are the ones we're gonna be using. This one is for the radio, like I just said, and this one is for our battery clip, which is gonna be attached to the battery. Over here, our battery, this is for, again, the battery clip, and this one is for charging the battery up. So I have a little bit of charge already on my battery. And on the other side of our brain, we have these holes that are like three pins for specific sensors, but we're not gonna use them for this video. That was a quick rundown on the brain. So let's get our motors now attached to our brain. So I'm just gonna go ahead and pick a size of the cables that I think can connect to the easiest one. You don't want to get one too big that you have to end up securing down later. And you don't want to have one too small that it becomes like really tight and not being able to work properly. So my motors are right here and my brain's right here, and it's on my plug. It's right over there on this side of my motor. So that's a pretty short distance. I'm gonna use a short one for this one. And I'm gonna go ahead, you can pick any numbers. It's labeled from 1 to 10 on the top and then 11 to 20 on the bottom. So it doesn't matter which one you connect it to. Once you hit a click, it's in. I'm gonna go ahead and attach it to 20. And I'm gonna find the same one. And just cause it's easier, we're gonna attach that. Just cause it's easier, I'm gonna attach this one to 11. And it's done. I might end up securing these down later because I don't want them flying around. So I might end up like securing them like this with zip ties. And we still need to attach our radio. So our radio is gonna be for controlling our robot with the remote control. So it sends out a signal of what we want it to do. And we don't really need a big one for that. So I'm gonna take another small one and plug it into the bottom of this. And we're gonna put it into the specific one for the radio. And I'm gonna secure it like that. So there we have our two motors connected to our brain and then our radio connected to our brain. So everything's attached to our brain now. And now let's go connect the brain to our computer. Okay guys, so here's what our computer is gonna look like when we open it up. VEXcode Pro V5. So this is where we're gonna be coding all our code for our robot. So this is what an empty project looks like. So when you hit file and you hit new, it's gonna allow you to create a project and name it. And then it opens up this blank project, but it already has some stuff inside. So let's check out what it already has. So it has these comments in the beginning, just a brief description of what it is about. You can add a description more in depth if you want, if you're creating a big lengthy project. This is just some intro stuff. The next few lines are going to be where we configure our devices. So this is going to be where the computer does the work for when we tell it what the robot looks like. The next line is include VEX.h. So this is going to be including header files so that we don't have to do the hard work of telling the computer what the robot looks like. And the next space is using namespace VEX, so just telling the computer, hey, we're using VEX for this. And then we're gonna have in the main method. So this main method, inside you can already tell, is an initializing robot configuration, and it says do not remove. So we're not gonna remove this because this is what initializes our VEX code and we need it to run. And in this main method, everything that you're gonna be writing in your code is gonna go inside your main method. All like the directions and the commands are gonna go inside main. Okay, so let's check out how we compile and build this. So we're gonna go into build on the top right corner, and there's this little blocks, and we're gonna click it. So that comes out and it says build complete, because obviously it's gonna build because we haven't coded anything, so there's no errors yet. If there was errors in your terminal, it's gonna output some errors and it's gonna tell you where you went wrong. So you can fix it if you have any. We don't have any yet because we didn't code anything. So we're gonna start configuring our robot on our computer. So there's this button over here. We're gonna, on the top right corner, we're gonna press it, and this is gonna bring up a robot configuration. So we can add our devices, and this is where we're gonna add our motors, our sensors, all this type of stuff we're gonna add in our robot configuration. So we're gonna click add device. And there's a bunch of devices here that we can add. You can feel free to play around with any of these because these are really cool sensors and motors and really cool stuff to play around with. But we only have a drivetrain right now at the moment, so we're gonna go and click drivetrain, two motors. We don't have one that's four motors yet because we only did one that's two motors. So we're gonna click drivetrain two motors, and it's gonna ask you where your left motor is. So which port did you plug it into? So we plugged ours into 11, and the next one, we plugged ours in to 20. And so now the next one asks you if you have a sensor or a gyro that calculates either turns or precise movements. But we don't have anything yet, right? We just have a basic drivetrain. So we're gonna click no gyro. So it's gonna ask you your drivetrain settings. This came standard with mine because I've been using this before, so this is what comes default. If yours is a little bit different, your gear cartridge, you can check that on your motor. But for now, this is what works for me, so I'm gonna click that. And there's a forward and backwards button, so you can tell your robot which way you're going to be moving if you say move forward. So when I say move forward, I want my robot to actually move forward. So I'm going to keep that one as that setting. So we're going to click done. And now you can already see that we have a new robot configuration listed here. And in our code, they're not actually, they're written as comments. So they're not going to be affecting our code, but they're written here, the name, the type, and the ports. So we know that this is now part of our configured robot. So the computer knows now that we have a drive chain. These are the ports where you're going to find it. And yeah, so that's added there. If we go into robot config.h, this is what our header file is and where the robot is getting configured. So you don't need to know this part. This is just a little bit more background information. So we added a drivetrain. So here is where our drivetrain is going to show up. Extern drivetrain, drivetrain. So it already externed the brain, and now it's externing our device that we just added, which is drivetrain. And extern basically just means make it open to everybody. So now we can use drivetrain wherever. So we don't have to worry about coding that per se, because our VEX Code Pro V5 already does that for us. Okay, and that's basically all you need to do for configuration. All you need to do is click that button over here, click add device, and then enter in the steps, and it automatically appears.
Okay guys, that is it. We did it. We connected our motors to our brain and then our brain to our computers. I hope you guys liked that video, because now you should be all set to code, so give it a big thumbs up, and I will see you guys next time.